There is no one on earth like him. He is blameless and upright, a man who fears God and shuns evil. So Job had no idea about the meaning of that the Lord had with Satan. But the Lord put Job up for the test. So had Job grown weary in what he was going through, he would have given up. Because he had three friends trying to convince him that maybe it was something that he did that caused the affliction and the pain on him. But nonetheless, Job kept going. And I used to think that when Job's wife asked him, does his integrity still, you know, does he still hold his integrity to the Lord? And she told him, you should curse God and die. And I thought maybe it was because of her love for him that she would rather see him die than to go through. But the bishop pointed out to us last week that it was still the plan of Satan. See, because Satan told God that if you take away everything that he has, he will curse you and die. So even when we're going through, you got to understand that Satan will use your family. Satan will use your loved ones. Yeah. And at the time that you're vulnerable and at your weakest moment, he will use them to come in and try to distract you from the course that God has put you on. Right. You know, I remember that some things was going on in my life a while back and some things that happened from a loved one or another, and I couldn't understand. Like, God, like, why would they say that? It hurts me. You know, it hurt. But at the same time, I couldn't go weary in my way of doing. I had to continue to stay on this race. You know, I remember telling my brother Nick in the back, you know, when we give our life to God, and we get on this Christian journey. Nick, I don't know if you remember this a few years ago, but I told you, you got to learn to expect things to happen. So when things happen, you're not caught by surprise. See, Satan has never, he does the same thing over and over. You know, he doesn't have any new tricks. So when Satan begins to use people to come at you, you got to understand that it's just a trick of the enemy. You know, and a lot of times, like I said, on this journey, things get rough. And we feel like, man, I had more money or I was happier when I was out in the street. That is a trick of the enemy. I come to encourage you not to grow weary in your way of doing. You know, it seems that we have more money. You know, when you're in the streets, you seem like, oh, man, everything is good. My money is like I want it to be. And then it's like when God begins, the Spirit of God begins to pull on you and you come to God, it seems like your money just evaporates in the thin air, you know. I even tried to write down everything I spent, and I still can't keep up. You know, it's like, what is going on? But that's just a trick of the enemy, because he comes to steal, kill, and to destroy. You know, and to deceive us, and to make us think, just like the children of Israel, that it's better to be in bondage than to be free. A lot of times, just like the children of Israel, we are free, but still have a slave mentality. You see what I'm saying? Like, we continue to let things hold us back and to keep us bound up. But we have victory in Christ Jesus. The thing about deliverance and the thing about healing is the moment that you ask for it, it was given. You just got to realize it and walk into it. You see what I'm saying? Like, but listen, we complain about this and God, this ain't going right, this ain't going right. But listen, without faith, it is impossible to please God.
Amen.
You got to put your faith in Christ Jesus that it will come to pass. So continue to stay on your journey and do not grow weary. And also, the Apostle Paul. Everyone knows the Apostle Paul. Everyone knows that he suffered many beatings and continued to be locked up most of his ministry. And what came to mind was 2 Timothy, chapter 4, verse 6. When Paul was on, he was talking to Timothy. He was basically saying that.
Okay.
He was basically saying, "For I am ready, being poured out like a drink offering, and the time for my departure is near. Listen, I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. Yeah. And guess what? I have kept the faith. Yeah. Now there is in store for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award to me on that day. And not only to me, but also to all who have longed for his appearing." See, Paul kept the faith through it all, through all the beatings, through all the persecution. He kept the faith. He longed to see God, to see Jesus face to face one day. He knew that as long as he stayed on this journey, he will get that crown of righteousness. So he didn't allow that thorn in his flesh. He didn't allow Satan or any tricks of Satan to distract him. And it's so easy to get distracted. I remember Even I was